Bangladesh looking into investing in the Philippines' pharmaceutical industry. After a meeting with Philippine President-elect Marcos, the Bangladeshi ambassador said his country is working on boosting the local manufacturing of COVID medicine and generic drugs in the Philippines. Ambassador Borhan Uddin cited what he described as the very booming pharmaceutical sector in Bangladesh. The country was the first to produce a generic version of anti-COVID drug Remdesivir. Bangladesh exports its pharmaceutical products to some 140 countries. After days of round-the-clock talks, the World Trade Organization finally seals a package of trade deals that include pledges on food security. This comes amid a global food crisis worsened by Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The package also touched on health security. WTO members agreed to waive COVID vaccine patents temporarily to make it easier to manufacture and export the jabs.
In response to the ongoing shocks from COVID-19, the declaration you just adopted will make access to medical supplies and components more predictable in this pandemic and in the next one. The TRIPS waiver compromise will contribute to ongoing efforts to deconcentrate and diversify vaccine manufacturing capacity so that a crisis in one region does not leave others cut off.
WTO members also agreed to curb subsidies for illegal fishing. The agency's 164 members passed the deals after 5 days of grueling talks at its headquarters in Geneva. The WTO Director General hailed the agreements as unprecedented. Poland is working hard to stabilize the export and prices of Ukrainian wheat. That's according to Poland's ambassador to the Philippines, who paid a courtesy visit to President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. this morning. Wheat prices remain high as a war between Russia and Ukraine continues to affect the global supply chain.
We're working hard to assure the export of the Ukrainian wheat that it's creating there's a big problem in terms of the increase of the prices of bread and some commodities.
Nigeria ready to work with the Philippines to help the country cope with rising fuel prices. Its ambassador also paid a courtesy visit to President-elect Marcos. During that meeting, she says Nigeria can help stabilize oil prices here in the country. But she adds no formal plans about the possible partnership have been drafted yet.
I actually mentioned to the president-elect as well that Nigeria is number 12 oil producer in the world, so we can help. We are number 3 natural gas producer in the world, so because I know he's keen on green energy. So we talked about natural gas as well. So Nigeria is ready to collaborate and work with Philippines. The most important thing is that the opportunity is there, and from there we can work it out in such a way that will be convenient and comfortable to the two nations.
The Philippine Central Bank not seeing stagflation as an immediate risk to the domestic economy. Stagflation happens when there is slow economic growth, high inflation, and high unemployment rate. The BSP remains optimistic the Philippines will sustain its economic recovery. It cited the country's stronger than expected GDP in the first quarter, a steady upturn in credit activity, and improving consumer confidence. It adds, while inflation is seen to remain elevated in the near term, it is expected to revert to government's target range of 2-4% by 2023. Inflation in the Philippines soared to 5.4% in May, driven by higher oil and commodity prices. The World Health Organization sounds the alarm over the drop in COVID testing. It notes fewer tests have been administered as COVID cases decline globally. But the WHO believes this would make it more difficult to track the spread of the coronavirus and its subvariants.
What we're seeing more and more is people are doing rapid tests at home, and none of those tests are getting reported in the system. The input has reduced, the sequencing has drastically done. So we are flying in blind, and the way Maria said, it's very uncomfortable to understand what we are saying, the BA4, 5, what does that mean?
The Omicron variant is less likely to cause long COVID compared to other variants. Long COVID is the condition wherein recovered patients still experience prolonged effects of the disease. Researchers at King's College London found the odds of developing long COVID after infection were 20 to 50% lower during the Omicron wave in the UK compared to Delta. But that figure still varies depending on the patient's age and the timing of their last vaccination. The researchers add more work was needed to establish why Omicron poses a lower long COVID risk. The Philippines logged 425 new COVID cases Thursday, the highest daily increase since April 3rd. The National Capital Region accounted for 214 of the new infections. But the Health Department says the NCR remains at low risk. The total number of active cases now stands at 3,462, the highest since May 10.